Hi, I'm Roland and welcome to Spice and Pans. Today, I'm happy and honoured to partner with Cordlife, a Singapore homegrown brand, to bring you a series of confinement food recipes. These recipes are extremely easy to prepare and super duper yummy. I've also invited Dr Wong Boh Boi, Singapore's very own baby whisperer, to explain to you why these dishes are good for you. In case you haven't heard, Cordlife operates the largest network of cord blood and tissue banks in Asia. They have a huge processing and storage facility in Singapore and in 5 other countries, serving more than 500,000 parents in Asia. Expectant parents today are storing their babies' cord blood and cord tissue so that their family will have more treatment options in the future. Stem cells that can be found in cord blood have been used to treat many conditions such as leukemia. There are also many ongoing clinical trials in the world now looking at using cord blood and cord tissue for more treatments. If you or someone in the family is expecting a baby now, consider storing the cord blood and cord tissue for your baby and your family. Hi, good day to you, Dr. Wong. How are you feeling today?
Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm great.
I hope you have a good day as well.
Definitely. Okay, today I'll be cooking green papaya milky fish soup. Could you basically tell us why is this soup good for ladies on confinement?
Oh, this is a very special soup. I did the research on it as well as study. Number one, it's a very nourishing and it's warm and it's very hearty soup. And it's clear, low in calories. The fish, you know, is contained all the goodness of the easily digest protein and also all the minerals from iron to, you know, iodine to magnesium to potassium to calcium because of the bones itself. And even vitamins, which is very vital for a nourishing, balanced diet. So that's why we choose fish bones rather than the flesh, which is the waste after you cook for some time. But we keep some pieces like you, I know, for deco, so the mother can eat. So purely is the bones. And for the papaya, it's very beneficial because we use green papaya. Why green papaya? Number one, green papaya is high fibers. And mother, after delivery, a bit constipated. So it helps a little because high fibers and also aid digestion because the enzyme inside there help you to digest and then it make to cleanse the guts itself because of the latex. You know, the latex that from green papaya is higher. So that although it's a bit sensitive to some mother's skin, but once you cook, it's fine. It's only preparation, we wear gloves.
Okay.
That's all. And at the same time, you know, there is a lot of enzymes inside it. Actually, the enzyme contains oxytocin, which is one of the enzymes involved in regulation of the milk production. But at the same time, also it is anti-inflammatory because a mother after delivery may got a little bit of like wound, like episiotomy cut or cesarean section cut, the wound itself, it helps anti-inflammatory and it helps you to a healing process. So after all, it's such a good things all around, so why not?
Yeah.
And it's easy. Is it easy to prepare?
Very, very easy.
Super easy. You always make things easy.
We try to. Also, some of the mothers might want to know what is the difference between this kind of fish soup as compared to herbal-based soup.
Okay, let's talk about herbal-based, like black chicken soup. Last time we cooked,
yes.
Because our cosmetin present, the chemical, is got antioxidants. All right, so it's a clear soup, also healthy soup, and then it's nourishing the mother in proteins. Mm-hmm. All right, you need some protein. This also contains protein, but it's different because it's helping mother in milk production itself, right? Oh. Because chicken soup hasn't got it. Mm-hmm. And the trotter is different. It's after delivery, we need to nourish and help the joint and the ligament to repair. And then recover from there. And also the vinegar is also a cleansing. Mother after delivery may have a bit low care, so it helps a little bit.
Okay, before we end this talk, do you have any general tips for ladies on confinement?
Basically, when during confinement, you must debunk those myths like no bathing. That is not true. You have to bathe in warm water, not cold water, because cold water sometimes it causes muscle spasm. And then people think that because of rheumatism, may not true. Wipe herself, make sure she dry herself, especially the creases of the fingers and the hand and the wrist. So do some simple exercise and then generally have good knowledge in what is called balanced diet. And then involve a lot in nursing her baby, but make sure that she knows what is nourishing, what is good for her, to help her feel good. Because nursing mother is a very tired, it's a tedious job. You got to repeat all the time. So like black chicken soup, which is like an essence of chicken, when you brew it in this way, it actually helps her to overcome this tiredness. And mother can be a bit forgetful, so the concentration can be improved a bit. All right, all this is nourishing, so I think it's good.
Great. So thank you so much, Dr. Wong. I will now proceed to cook this dish, and hopefully we'll talk soon.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. I watch you.
Wong. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye.
We will now blanch our fish bones. I have with me over here 300 grams of fish bones. I'm using red grouper fish bone. You can use any fish bones that you have. Or you can get. Just put them in room temperature water inside a pot before we turn on the heat. Place everything in. Once you have put in the bones, we'll turn on the heat and let this come to a boil. Once the water comes to a boil, we'll boil this for another 5 minutes. 5 minutes have passed, we'll give the fish bones a light rinse and we can pour away the water. Now we'll put the dish together. I'm boiling over here 1.5 liters of water. I'm adding in 150 grams of anchovies, rinse. Just put them in. Add in the fish bones. Add in 5 red dates. 1 whole bulb of garlic. Add in 300 grams of green papaya. Take off the skin and cut them into cubes like this. Just pour everything in. We will let this come to a boil and then we will turn down the heat to low and let this simmer for 1.5 hours. I'll see you back in a while. We've been boiling the fish soup for 1.5 hours. Let's have a look. Wow, smells really, really fantastic. We'll remove the fish bones as well as the anchovies before we add in the sliced fish. Now that I have removed the fish bones, the anchovies and the garlic, I'll add in the sliced fish. I'm using over here 140 grams of Toman fish, sliced thinly like this and coated slightly with corn flour just to have a better texture. Make sure that the soup is boiling before we add in the fish. Adding fish in is optional. If you want to have the fish, you'll be good to make a complete meal. Otherwise, you can just drink the soup, no problem. Once you have added in the fish, you'll add in the wolf berries. Just sprinkle a little bit of wolf berries and we'll let this cook for approximately 3 minutes or so. And after that, we'll just serve this. And the green papaya milky soup is done. Let's have a taste. Try the soup first. Wow, you don't need any more seasoning inside here. The taste of the anchovies, the fish bone, this is really very enriching to the body. This is really nice. We'll try the fish. The texture is really, really very good. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope you like our video. Do click like on our video and do subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. One more bowl, please. Before I go, if you're pregnant now, do consider cord blood banking with Cordlife.